Yo, what's up? Welcome back to another episode of the Suas. As I'm recording this, it's the fourth quarter of the Packers Raiders. It looks like we're gonna get the under, but Packers plus two. Love just threw his second pick. Raiders have the ball up 17-13, so that side's not looking great. Hopefully by the time you're watching this, the Packers have come back and covered. We'll see. But let's move on to Tuesday, because we got college football on, Conference USA action. Tuesday night football, let's roll.
Welcome to the Suas. Get the Suas.
First up, Louisiana Tech on the road at Middle Tennessee. Middle Tennessee, man, I'm still pissed about that game last week. This line's at MTSU minus three. Again, same as last week. Total sitting at 54.5. Public's pretty split even on this one. I haven't seen this line budge from three. We're still looking at three across the board. Looks like sharp action came in on Middle Tennessee early, but as of right now, it's looking like three across the board. So these two teams played last season. It was actually the first time they met since 2016. Louisiana Tech beat them up pretty comfortably. That was actually the game where Vadiato took over as a starting quarterback. He came in, they were down 16. I'm pretty sure he got sacked and fumbled on his first play in the game too. So if you're subscribed to this channel, you know what happened with Middle Tennessee last week. I really like Middle Tennessee minus three, thought it was a great sharp play. They blew a 16-point second half lead. They lost 45-30. They had 563 yards of offense in the game. Still found a way to lose. I was so pissed during that. Now, the reason I liked Middle Tennessee so much last week was the matchup they had. Middle Tennessee, as we know, their offense heavily relies on Vadiato in the passing game. And Jacksonville State's defense is terrible against the pass. I like the matchup. I don't know if we necessarily have the same type of matchup here this week. Louisiana Tech analytically is better against the pass. Their defense is 123rd overall, 126th in effective rush, and 108th in effective pass. Now, I know you might be looking at these ranks and being like, yo, this defense is terrible. But keep in mind, we're handicapping Conference USA football here. I mean, look at Middle Tennessee's offensive rankings for reference. 119th overall, 120th in effective rush, 93rd in effective pass. Just wanted to show you that because I know a lot of people might be brand new to betting Conference USA football. These numbers look about right. I mean, it's Conference USA. But anyway, these analytics are showing us that Louisiana Tech's defense is slightly stronger against the pass. Now, if you look at their game logs, you might find a couple games that make you question that. North Texas, for example, they went on the road into Louisiana Tech, and Chandler Rogers threw for 313 yards, two touchdowns, no picks, with a 142 passer rating. But you have to look at these games in context, because since Chandler Rogers took over as the starting quarterback there in North Texas, he's been averaging over 300 yards a game. They just went on the road to Annapolis and almost beat Navy last week. That North Texas offense is dangerous right now. Austin Reed also had a great game throwing the ball on this Louisiana Tech defense, 297 yards, three touchdowns, a 152 passer rating. But it's Austin Reed. He threw for 4,700 yards last season. He led the country. If those are the only two games where Louisiana Tech was getting beat via the pass, I can live with that. Now, on the road at Middle Tennessee, it's unrealistic to think Louisiana Tech is going to stop this passing attack from moving the ball. I mean, especially at home. Vadiato's been much more efficient at home. He's averaging 326 passing yards a game on 8.4 yards per attempt and a 155 passer rating in his three home games. For reference, he has a 109.9 passer rating on the road. So Middle Tennessee is going to move the ball in this game. But we have to ask ourselves, does it really matter? Because Middle Tennessee just continuously shoots themselves in the foot. They've lost their last three games. They're 0-3 in their last three. They're allowing 407 yards a game and 35.7 points per game in those games. They actually outgained their opponent in two of them. So they're outgaining their opponents and still losing. Another reason I liked Middle Tennessee last week is they could stop the run. Now, they don't have an electric run defense, but it's decent. It's the strength of their defense. And Jacksonville State can only run the ball. They can't throw it at all. Sonny Cumbie and this Louisiana Tech offense, they're not built like that at all. The Bulldogs throw the ball a lot. Their starting quarterback, Hank Bachmeier, has been hurt for a few weeks now. They're still throwing the shit out of the ball. And now Hank Bachmeier should be set to return to the field. He was questionable last week, and I believe he dressed. I think he was available, just not starting. So you would assume, if that was his status last week, that he'd be ready to play this week. If Hank Bachmeier is playing, I don't think Louisiana Tech is going to have any problems moving the ball up and down the field on this Middle Tennessee defense. But I don't love the idea of my bet relying on turnovers, because if Middle Tennessee is able to protect the football, they're going to score. I mean, we saw them do it against Jacksonville State. I mean, they shot themselves in the foot. They would have scored 55-60 points if it wasn't for those turnovers and the muff punt, which is why I think the safest move here is just play the over at 54.5. If Middle Tennessee is able to protect the football, they'll score a bunch of points. Good for us. If they end up shooting themselves in the foot, turning the ball over, probably results in points for Louisiana Tech. Still good for us. As far as betting aside, if Hank Bachmeier is confirmed playing, which they probably won't even tell us till the last second, if that. But if I could find out that Hank Bachmeier is confirmed playing and I could still get Louisiana Tech at the full plus three, I will play it. I'll take it. If it doesn't end up playing, I'll probably just stick with the over next game. Liberty on the road at Jacksonville State. Another Conference USA game here. Jacksonville State catching 6 points at home. Total sitting at 56.5. So this line's been at 6. It did touch 5.5 for a few hours early Monday morning, but it's back at 6 now. Public is all over Liberty. Heavy. Tickets on Liberty, handle on Liberty. Seems like everyone's betting Liberty here. So this is a huge game. These two teams are currently tied at the top of Conference USA standings, both currently perfect 3-0, undefeated in the conference. Winner of this game will be 4-0 and have sole possession of first place. This decision was pretty simple for me. I mean, the reason I faded Jacksonville State last week, I'm going to reiterate what I said in the last game, I was worried about the pass defense against Middle Tennessee. That's a pass-first offense. Jacksonville State has had some really shaky defensive performances against passing offenses. And we even saw it last week. Jacksonville State, like I said earlier, they won the game, but Middle Tennessee had 563 yards of offense. Jacksonville State's defense against the run is much better. They're the 81st overall ranked defense according to BetaRank, 107th in effective pass, 55th in effective rush. So Jacksonville State can defend the run. The last time Jacksonville State saw a run first offense was back in week 4 at home. Eastern Michigan is kind of ass, I'll give you that, but still, 35 carries for just 57 yards, 1.6 yards per carry. This Jacksonville State defense may not be loaded with talent, but the run defense is pretty good. Liberty is most definitely a run-first offense. In fact, running the ball is basically all they do. This season, Liberty has run the ball on 65.31% of their snaps. That's fifth most in the FBS. It goes Air Force, Navy, Army, West Virginia, then Liberty. So Liberty runs the shit out of the ball, and they're good at it. Liberty's 10th in the FBS in yards per carry, 3rd in rushing yards per game. So yes, Liberty being a run-first offense definitely plays right into the strength of the Jacksonville State defense. But to be fair, Jacksonville State hasn't seen anything close to Liberty's rushing attack yet. Now, on the other side of the ball, we're actually looking at a very similar offense here. Jacksonville State also runs the ball a lot, almost just as much as Liberty does. Liberty's 5th in the FBS in run frequency. Jacksonville State's 9th. Probably not going to see a ton of pass attempts in this game. And Jacksonville State's offense, just like their defense, analytically, they're very one-sided. No passing game at all, but Jacksonville State is ranked 60th in effective rush. That's a solid rank for a Conference USA program. Now, when we look at Liberty's defense, they're pretty balanced. They're actually slightly better against the pass, which won't do them much good against Jacksonville State. They're ranked 76th overall, 69th in effective pass, 80th in effective rush. And here's the kicker. Look at Liberty's opponents this season. They haven't seen a single decent rushing attack yet. The strongest run game Liberty's seen this entire season is New Mexico State, who currently sits at 92nd. Jacksonville State's going to be the best run game Liberty's seen so far this season. And think about the spot. You got Jacksonville State, right? It's their first year in the FBS. They're 5-1, a perfect 3-0, tied for first place in the conference. Rich Rod's got that program in high spirits right now. I don't know much about Jacksonville State's home stadium, home field environment, but I would imagine the spot they're in, that this place is going to be going nuts. Public's all over Liberty. I got to take the points here. I mean, is Liberty the better football team? Of course. I just don't like the matchup for them, and I don't know if they've shown us enough to be laying almost a full touchdown on a road against a team like this that's playing with a lot of confidence and a lot of energy. Give me Jacksonville State plus 6 next game. How about some more Conference USA football? Coastal Carolina on the road at Appalachian State. App State laying 6.5 at home. It's up from 6. Total sitting at 61. Public's definitely leading Coastal Carolina in this one. I would imagine this line comes back down to 6, maybe even 5.5. But as I'm recording this, it's Appalachian State minus 6.5 with the public on the Chanticleers. I'm actually going to skip this one for right now. I'm waiting for the line to come back down a little bit. I probably will end up posting a bet for this one on the website closer to kickoff. I don't see how Coastal Carolina can make stops in the run game here. And Appalachian State's defense has actually been really good against the pass, which we know that's what Coastal relies on with Grayson McCall at quarterback. So I'm probably leaning Appalachian State in this one, but I'm waiting it out. If you're subscribed to the website, you'll see. I'll post it on there. For my top bets, parlays of the day, if you'd like to join our Discord, or you want to get in the NFL against the spread giveaway contest, head over to kylekirms.com. All the information's right there on the homepage. College football week 7 is here. That means we're starting up with the Tuesday games. Gonna have football basically every night of the week for a long time. Really excited for it. Remember to bet responsibly, and I'll talk to you in the Discord.